You have been involved, in a great way, in fact, with the European Constitution. What is your opinion now? There seems to be a divide in Europe, whether Europe should actually become a superstate or a collection of states. How do you see it?
Well, I'm not entirely sure that this is a correct vision of the dilemma that we face. If you allow me, is a sort of British translation of the European dilemma. And whatever increase in the rate of integration, even if needed, is perceived beyond the channel in the UK as the nightmare of the superstate. I can tell you that Europe will never become a superstate. It's impossible for several reasons. Please believe me. The problem is not making of Europe a superstate. The problem, you see, is that we are nowadays increasing the rate of diversities that are included in our European Union. We started with 6 states, we went on with 9, and then with 12, and then with 15. Now we are 25, yes, and we're going to become even more than 25. There is no fixed relationship between the rate of integration that a supranational organization needs and its diversities. It depends. Now, in my view, if you want to remain what you were in the past, while increasing the rate of diversities, you also have to increase the rate of integration. Otherwise, you simply collapse. I tell you something very simple. We have a ministerial council at the European level, the members of which are ministers of our nation states. Yes. And therefore, initially, the ministerial council had 6 members, then 9, then 12, then 15, now 25. With 25 members, after a tour de table, after each of them has taken the floor once, their time is finished. They don't have the time to take a decision that they are supposed to take. And therefore, you have to change the rules of that game. The Constitution was about changing these rules of this game. Mm-hmm. Now, what I expect is a strengthening of the institutional devices of Europe, not to make it a super state, but to make it a functional European Union.